When is it allowed for police officers to be in civilian clothing?
Well, we have to understand, Ms. Carmina, that the use of civilian clothes is allowed during police operation, especially when they are conducting a manhunt operation and a undercover police operation, so as not to alert the subject of the police operation. In this case, according to them, they were conducting a legitimate manhunt operation to arrest the suspects who were earlier involved in a shooting incident. So that is now part of the our ongoing investigation, Ms. Carmina, on how this police officer were able to conduct this police operation under civilian clothes.
Remind us again, Colonel, how long has it been since they initiated their pursuit operations against this murder suspect?
As a background, Ms. Carmina, there was a reported shooting incident around 3 a.m. of August 2. The police station received a report. They immediately conducted a hot pursuit operation, which led to the arrest of one suspect. And after conducting interview with the arrested suspect, they received information based on witnesses' account that the other suspect in the police the shooting incident can be found in the Riverside. That prompted them to conduct a follow-up operation, which led them to the Riverside, wherein the operating team encountered the victim, who accordingly was upon seeing the presence of the police officer, immediately jumped from the river from a boat and attempted to escape, which prompted the police involved to fire a warning shot. And at least that is according to the version of the police involved this time.
And this is why it's important for us to establish that they were in civilian clothing, because Jem Boy could not have known that they were police officers. To him, probably, they were armed civilians. They were civilians carrying firearms.
That is correct, Ms. Carmina. We cannot fault the victim if he perceived the police officers as some criminal elements for wearing civilian clothes. But again, like I said, I mentioned earlier, the police officer claimed that they shouted and introduced themselves as police officers and commanded the person to stop. But again, this case will be discussed during the trial of the case. Criminal cases has already been filed against the six involved officers, and including their immediate supervisors were in fact included in the admin cases filed for common responsibility to determine if there is indeed failure of supervision on the part of their team leaders.
It was six police officers against one 17-year-old who just tried, or who dove into the water out of fear. Jem Boy wasn't armed, was he?
That is the information we gathered, Ma'am Carmina, that the victim is not in fact in arm, and that is why there is obviously a grave irregularity in the conduct of a police operation. One, they are in civilian clothes, although they could justify that they are conducting a legitimate police operation. But again, the use of firearms in this case is not really justified, because the police operational procedure is very clear on the instances where a police officer can use his firearms during police operation.
Understandably, a lot of people are questioning this operation. As you conduct your investigation, what was the explanation given? Why did they shoot upon Jem Boy Baltazar? Why did they break protocol? Why did they not follow procedures?
One of the justification they said, Ms. Carmina, is that they commanded the person to surrender upon seeing that the subject is escaping and jump from the boat, but he did not stop, which compelled them to allegedly fire a warning shot, which accidentally hit. That, at least, again, that is the contention of the police involved. And this is now the subject of our ongoing investigation. And during the trial of the case, this claim of the police officers will be established, whether it is really justifiable on their part to really fire their firearms to think that the victim is not it's not armed in this case, and very clear there is a very clear violation of the existing police operational procedure, particularly the use of firearms of this police officer, Ms. Carmina.
Tell us though, Colonel, when the use of warning shots, it's not even allowed under your rules. What could they have done? If it is true that they introduced themselves as police officers, if it is true that they commanded them, Jemboy and his friend, to sort of submit and stand down, and they didn't, what could these police officers have done?
The police operational procedure is very clear on the use of firearms, Ms. Carmina, and like what you mentioned, the use of warning shot is even not allowed in any instances, except of course if the police officer is outnumbered and he thinks that his life is in imminent danger, then he can make a warning shot. However, the use of the firearms in this case is very clear, and there is no need to use firearms. They could have used other non-lethal approach to apprehend the supposed suspect of their police operation. Because we have recalled as force continuum, depending on the situation and the circumstances, they could have also attempt to go to the waters and make attempt to arrest the suspect, which turned out not to be the one they are looking for.
But obviously, they didn't do all those that you just mentioned, Colonel. How long have all of these six police officers been in service?
Well, as you see, the one of the suspects here involves a patrolman, a corporal, and the highest ranking officer here is a police executive master sergeant. So more or less, if you can see their rank, the minimum they're serving the police service is at least 3 years or 3 years and above.
3 years and above, and yet they don't know the rules, the procedures. How do you explain that?
That is very sad, Ma'am Carmina, that in spite of our limited reminders, and this is where the accountability of their team leaders will come in. That is why during the filing of the admin case, their team leaders were also included because of the doctrine of common responsibility. We need to investigate and find out if indeed prior to the conduct of the police operation, there were briefings conducted by the team leaders to remind our police officers on the proper use of their firearms and the do's and don'ts in the conduct of the police operation. So they will be made accountable together with their police officer.
Colonel, there are those who are asking, why can't you release the names of these police officers?
We already released the names of the police officer, Ma'am Carmina. In fact, the cases filed before the prosecutor's office, all the names of the personnel involved here are already cited, Ms. Carmina.
Okay, so they've been made public already. So they've been made public already. All right.
Yes, ma'am. The documents can be accessed by the family, and the family were in fact assisted by no less than the chief of police at the Nabotas police station during the filing of the cases before the prosecutor's office.
Okay. So let's move on with the next question. When did these police officers realize that they killed the wrong person?
Well, we presume that that the time that they discovered that the person they accidentally killed was not the person involved in the shooting earlier is when the body of the dead victim was recovered from the river. That's probably the instance when they discovered that they were able to kill a wrong person here, Ms. Carmina.
Because that's another issue here, Colonel. Are you also going to look into that? They shot and killed a person and left the person in the waters.
That is part of our ongoing investigation, Ms. Carmina, to determine whether after the incident, after accidentally hitting the subject, whether they initiated a appropriate action to bring the victim to the hospital, at least make an effort to bring him to the hospital and to for possible so that he could at least make an attempt to at least assist the victim that were shot during the police operation. Because it could have been probably instances where they could have at least saved the victim from dying.
But obviously, once again, they didn't. It took another person to fish, retrieve Jemboy's body out of the water.
Again, Ma'am Ms. Carmina, that is part of the ongoing investigation that I really cannot answer your question right now. If they really, if after the conduct of a police operation, they left the scene. So that is another issue that should be addressed, and the police officer involved should answer if indeed there is a proof that they left the scene immediately after the incident. What could have they done is to at least make an effort to save the victim. If there is any truth that they left the victim after hitting him, then that's another grave error on their part.
The police force, Colonel, as you know, was under fire during the Duterte administration for the many killings in the hands of police officers back then. Tell us why this latest incident shows that the force has learned from the past.
Well, this unfortunate incident, Ms. Carmina, we still consider this an isolated case. This is not really the policy and norms within the PNP organization. And we want to assure not only the family but the public that this will not be countenanced, this will not be tolerated. That's why immediately after the incident, the Chief of Police of Nabotas immediately castigated the police personnel. They took their firearms. Corresponding criminal cases were filed against them. They are now currently detained in the police station. As a reminder to everyone that this kind of misdeeds and misactions on the part of our police officers will never be tolerated, not only by the Nabotas police station but the PNP leadership. And as you mentioned earlier, there are instances that there are some instances, police operations of the previous administration were questioned. But again, we keep on telling that on the part of the PNP, we cooperated with the investigation being conducted to thresh out this questionable police operation. And we will keep on reiterating that we will cooperate with any investigation.
Colonel? Okay, we seem to have lost Colonel.
Hello, ma'am.
Yeah, Colonel, go ahead. Are you okay?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, go ahead. Your final thoughts on the matter?
Well, we want to assure not only the family of the victim, Ms. Carmina, as well as the public, that the PNP leadership will never tolerate this kind of misaction in this deed on the part of some of the police officers. We want to assure the family that we will assist them in these cases, and will never tolerate, and will not give any special treatment with respect to this case, particularly to those 6 or 8 police personnel involved in this unfortunate incident.
All right, and we're going to have to leave it at that. PNP spokesperson there, Colonel Gene Fajardo, thanks for taking our call.
Thank you, ma'am.